Erev Tov Chaverim, I'm Stephen Benoon. You are watching Israeli News Live and on your screen here on the news site AMN, an Arabic news channel here, you are seeing the results of a young man, the one not in the white, but the one in the camouflage looking uniform there. He's only 13 years old, according to the alleged report here. They are marching him off to his death. Now, this happens to be part of the, and I will not show that, it's too graphic of a video there. I do not want to show what happens here. This is exactly the results of the U.S.-backed rebels, Al-Qaeda, Al-Nusra, ISIS, all these groups here. This is the way that they react to children, and this is what the U.S. government is backing as of right now. Now, not the U.S. people. I want to make sure we make that clear. It is the Obama administration that is backing these types of people here inside of Syria, inside of Aleppo, and they are saying for the Russians to stop the air campaign. What you're not being told is exactly what these thugs are doing to the civilians as well as other people there in the region. Anyway, this young man here was shot in the back of the head moments after this video started. And of course, as we're seeing all the different types of things that are happening there in the Middle East, it's getting very serious in Syria. And the provocations that are coming, especially from the United Nations Security Council, provoking Russia, a provocation that just never seems to end, is causing Russia to react by moving nuclear-capable missiles into Kaliningrad. Kaliningrad is, those of you that may not know, is right there north of Poland there. So yes, the Russian bear is being provoked, and we're going to go into that in just a moment here. And the radius that they have is 440-mile radius of the nuclear warheads that they brought into Kaliningrad. It is within striking distance of Berlin, Warsaw, all the different areas of that region there. These are more of a medium-range type of missile. But Russia is starting to do the exact same things that the United States Obama administration has been doing, which they move nuclear warheads into Armenia after doing the fake staged coup against Erdogan, only to justify to be able to move around their nuclear arsenal while Russia was not paying attention to what was really going on. At least that one slipped past Russia from what I can tell at any rate there. Let me show you those. Let's just bring it to the fact that what we're seeing. Nigel Farage states this here. I want you to hear what he has to say. He is a British politician about Russia, because I know there's some people that think, well, you're just backing Russia, and you know, Russia's the bad evil empire. Well, you know, the thing is, Russia's not the bad evil empire. Russia is trying to deal with a bunch of terrorists that are there in Aleppo, that had the United States not came in there and backed them, had the U.S. Obama administration come and helped Russia, who they had an outstretched hand continually for the U.S. government, the Obama administration, to come and fight against ISIS, then we would not be seeing the issue in Aleppo today. But no, it was just to the contrary. The Obama administration has been, put it bluntly, hell-bent on making sure they get rid of Assad. And they don't care what kind of thugs they back, such as what you saw just a moment ago. If somebody dare insults Allah, according to what they did there, they take a little boy out and just shoot him in the back of the head, not thinking that he's just a little kid that doesn't, maybe has a slip of the tongue and doesn't know he's angry or something. No, just go ahead and kill him. That's the type of thugs that the Obama administration is backing. Let's take a listen here. What he actually says here.
Contradictions of the last few years, including, of course, the bombing of Libya, the desire to arm the rebels in Syria, has been the unnecessary provocation of Vladimir Putin. This EU empire, ever seeking to expand, stated its territorial claim on the Ukraine some years ago. Just to make that worse, of course, some NATO members said they too would like the Ukraine to join NATO. We directly encouraged the uprising in the Ukraine that led to the toppling of the president Yanukovych, and that led, of course, in turn to Vladimir Putin reacting. And the moral of the story is, if you poke the Russian bear with a stick, don't be surprised when he reacts. Now, just to continue with that, today we are rushing through an association agreement at undue speed with the Ukraine. And as we speak, there are NATO soldiers engaged in military exercises in the Ukraine. Have we taken leave of our senses? Do we actually want to have a war with Putin? Because if we do, we're certainly going about it the right way. Perhaps we ought to recognize that the West now faces the biggest threat and crisis.
And of course, Nigel is actually speaking here about the Syrian situation there and what's going on the ground with, Ukraine. But it's only a reflection of what we are seeing as well over the Syrian conflict. Ukraine is definitely, Russia has been provoked into reacting. One of the things that we have said, as we see that President Bashar al-Assad invited Russia in to be able to help him deal with the crisis that he's facing with U.S.-backed rebels and ISIS and everyone else in his country trying to topple him. Also, President Yanukovych invited Russia in to rescue him from this coup that was being done, backed by CIA agents there inside of Ukraine. So it is clearly, unfortunately, the Obama administration has really taken the nation down a very bad direction. And in fact, I have to say, I was very surprised when I heard Donald Trump, the presidential nominee, state in his own debate there with Hillary Clinton that he disagreed with Mike Pence as running mate. I was very concerned that he was very much for it and had the change of mind, maybe perhaps due to some of the latest information coming out of Washington of a possible war, a possible strike on Syria, which would include Russia, after some of his comments that I heard earlier. But to see that he is still willing to make peace with Russia, still wanting to make peace with Putin, this is what we need. So when they hung the signs, the flags there in New York City of Vladimir Putin, peacemaker, over on the bridges there, there are people around the world that are trying to show that Russia has had an outstretched hand with the West to try to bring peace, try to battle, try to fight ISIS, whom the United States created, but even with Russia very much aware of that, not the United States, but the Obama administration. Again, I want to stand corrected on that. But the Obama administration created this group here, but Russia is still, even though they know that, they're saying, okay, you know that you did wrong. You made a humanitarian crisis for the entire Middle East, but let's fight together. Let's get rid of them. But instead, it's been the other way around. What has the Obama administration done? They arm them more. They help them unite together so they can turn around and tell the Russians, sorry, they're all part of the moderate rebels now. Therefore, do not touch them. Do not bomb them. We'll bring about a no-fly zone. And if you don't obey, then we will come in and attack. It has just turned into a just complete mess. Okay, and one other further thing in the news here I want to share with you. This is something that you're not being told whatsoever going on. We do know that there were missile strikes towards a U.S. ship off the coast of Yemen by the Houthi rebels. But what you may not realize is just how powerful the Houthi rebels have become with their own technology inside of Yemen. In fact, not only did they try to strike the ship that was offshore, according to their own claim, two soldiers were injured by it, but they do admit that the missiles did not strike the ship itself. But these guys here have developed ballistic missiles that have a range of 850 kilometers, and they struck deep within inside of Saudi Arabia there. It was very much a surprise to the entire region there that they are developing ballistic missiles right there in Yemen, capable of striking. They struck Saudi Arabia with 650 kilometers inside of Saudi Arabia, the deepest that they've ever been able to achieve. These missiles that went out, and then we find later in the video here, let me just take it, someone else caught it where it was landing in Saudi Arabia there, and doing a lot of damage, no doubt, what they sent in. So there again, according to the article here, the attack, which is by far the deepest in the Saudi kingdom, came 2 days after Saudi airstrikes killed and wounded more than 650 people in attack on a funeral held in Yemeni capital. Dubbed Burqan 1, the 12.5 meter long ballistic missile is developed locally by Yemeni experts, which range up to 800 kilometers. In the same context, two missiles fired from rebel-controlled territories in Yemen landed near a U.S. destroyer in the Red Sea, wounding two sailors, but without causing material damage, according to the U.S. Navy. This is exactly what we see going on. It is the entire Middle East has just become a hotbed. And, you know, and unless someone in the Obama administration or in the possible next presidency ends up coming with some senses there and working with Russia rather than trying to create a war directly with Russia, create a direct confrontation with Russia, I'm afraid we're going to see an all-out catastrophe in Europe, the United States, everywhere that you could possibly imagine. As we said, now Russia, and Russia is saying that this is done on drills. This article here actually came out on Mail Online, but I've actually looked at it already on other articles as well. Russia does say that they did this for military drills, and it is the missiles are nuclear capable warheads. Anyway, it is a very serious situation, and I do believe that we are seeing, just as Nigel pointed out, we are seeing that the Russian bear is being prodded, and he may be something that might be something that we cannot revert. I'm Stephen Benoon with Israeli News Live, Erev Tov.